Cosmic Shimmer Gilding Polish is water-based, packaged with a built-in foam applicator, and as of December 2017, available in 24 colors. In today's video, I'll demo some interesting ways to use it, some taking advantage of that handy built-in applicator, plus I'll use some other tools. Interestingly enough, I discovered that Pitt Pens and Pebeo's water-based markers write directly on a dried layer of gilding polish, allowing you to use it as a background while not necessarily limiting what you can do on top. No matter if it's your fingers, the foam applicator, or a brush, I think you're going to like this product. So this gilding polish is water-based. There's no wax in it. It's intermixable, so you can create custom colors. You can layer it. It works on most porous surfaces. The interesting thing about this is the way that it's packaged. So you have these glass jars with this lid that you screw off, and you see the product inside. And the applicator, this foam applicator, you snap it to the side like that and that lifts it out, and it's built right into the cap. So you always have a way to get the product out of the jar without sticking your fingers in there. And that's important because no matter how clean you think your hands are, you're liable to get something in there that causes it to get a little funky. You might see some mold growing or whatever. Using the applicator or using a palette knife to scoop the product out is going to pretty much eliminate that possibility. So when you work with this, it's just a matter of taking the lid off, taking your applicator. Now I have a fair amount in the lid. It's recommended, before I forget, it's recommended that you just rinse this with some clear water to begin with the first time you use it. And if you want to clean it afterward with a little bit of soap and water, you can certainly do that. Then you just snap it back inside the cap. So anyway, I'm going to grab a little bit of this, and you can see that I've got it on the product. Now rather than just kind of smear that on, I like to work it into the foam a little bit before I try to use it. And you can see that this is a pretty light color. But you'll notice that it provides nice coverage on here. Now this is a very lustrous, pearlescent, metallic-y looking polish. That's the whole point of it. It's supposed to give you that kind of a finish. But I like the fact that it works on this black surface, and I can just go along and get a coating on there. And even though it's light, same kind of business. Let me just grab some more here. I can easily cover the chipboard and get a really nice effect. So it works on lots of different porous surfaces. You can get plenty of effects. So let's, while I have some of this out, let's just go ahead and grab a little bit of this color, which is named Blossom. I'm not going to use too much because it's just going to get wasted. I'm going to snap this back in the lid, put the cover back on, and I'm going to bring in a little bit of rich red, and I'm going to do the same thing. Actually, I'm going to scrape a little bit right out of the lid. Now this is fairly dark, but you can see that I can mix this up, create an entirely, ooh, that's pretty. I can create an entirely new color, this kind of rosy color. And yes, I don't want to contaminate the lids that, or the, excuse me, the applicators that come in a cap, but this is where an ink blending tool comes in. Now the foam on this is a little denser than the foam that comes with the applicator. So for the purposes of using, applying the product through a stencil, I'm going to do this instead. And so you can see I can pick this color up, and I've got it on my ink blending tool. Now here's the interesting thing. I can just come along and apply this. Oh, that's a really pretty color. I can apply this. This is just watercolor paper, and I'm sneaking some three new designs of watercolor art parts in here at the same time. These are called wing things. So this is one of the styles of butterflies. And it's just a matter of applying the color like that. Now this stuff dries pretty quickly. It's said that you can buff it and you can use a soft cloth to do that. It kind of aligns the mica particles and makes it shimmery. But I gotta tell you, right from the package, it creates a really pretty pearlescent finish. And as I mentioned in the introduction, one of the things that I like about this is that I can come back and I can use my Pitt pens on this. And, oh, that's interesting where I've kind of brought some of the lighter color in. Sorry, got distracted there for a second. Once this is dry, I can use a Pitt pen, or I can use one of the Pebeo water-based paint markers, and I can write on here without any difficulty. So this is kind of the basics. Let me clean up, and then I'm going to come back, and I'll show you a couple of other really interesting techniques. But this stuff is so easy to use. It's a really marvelous product. Gilding polish is a pretty versatile product. I'm going to show you how easy it is to use it to ink up a stamp and stamp. So I have a couple of our Joggles stamps, a couple of colors. This is, again, one of those new watercolor art parts. This is just a piece of Strathmore Bristol paper that's got some color on it. So it's very straightforward to do this. I'm going to, you can see I've started here. So I'm going to grab, this is our background noise dots stamp. I'm going to grab some of the color on here. Again, I can just take some out of the lid. I'm going to kind of smoosh it around so that I get it kind of evenly distributed on the foam, and then I'm just going to tap it on there. go ahead and stamp. And you can see how easily that works. So I can stamp, whoops, I can stamp on something that already has gilding polish on it, or if I want, whoops, I can just go ahead and I can stamp on something else that doesn't have anything on it. And you see that it works equally as well. And I really love the fact that this stuff works on dark surfaces. So I'm just going to spray some water off to the side and put that stamp face down. Let's close this one up and grab the next color. Oops. All right. So is this a different stamp? Yep, it is. Does it work on all stamps? I haven't found one that it doesn't. You can see I didn't do a particularly good job cleaning that the last time I used it. So this stamp doesn't want to stick because the back has got something all over it and it's interfering with the cling. So I'm just going to use a little bit of water and that helps hold it in place. So again, same process. What I want you to see is that even though this stamp is far finer, the process works just as well. I can get a nice crisp image as long as I'm thoughtful about how much of the color that I put on there. Doesn't take a lot of pressure, and you can see how pretty that is. It works. It's a finely detailed stamp. See all those little circles in the center? It produces that image without any difficulty at all. And then the best part, of course, is how pretty and shimmery and shiny it is. The last couple of things I want to show you is working with gilding polish and stencils, and then I want to take advantage of the fact that this is a water-based product. I want to thin it out to make a wash that you can brush onto something or you can spatter, which is something that I like to do. Now the nice part is that you're going to thin it out enough to make it a little bit more transparent, but you're still going to see all the shimmer it's in there. So working with a stencil first, you'll notice I have an ink blending tool. The foam on this is denser than the foam that comes with the applicator that's built into the cap. So I'm going to work with this because I think from the way I work, I get a little bit better results. I'm going to grab a little bit of the product. I'm going to put it out on my nonstick craft sheet. Now I'm going to put out more than I need because this is, I'll make a wash out of what's left of that. Just put the cover back on. Grab my ink blending tool. Now again, too much, anytime you put something through a stencil, too much is never going to be a good thing, but I want to get some worked into the foam so I get good coverage. And this is one of our 6x9 stencils. I'm not doing anything fancy here, I just want to show you that I can get this color through the openings of the stencil. It gives me that really pretty, really super nice shimmer, but because I have this applicator, the ink blending tool, rather than the applicator itself, I find that I get far better results. But you're going to see in a second when I lift this how nice and crisp the image is. Now I got a little bit heavy right here and you can see that that ridge that kind of builds up here is much better because I had less of the product on there. You'll do a better job than I did because you're not going to be rushing to try to get through it. So with what's left here, I'm going to add some water. I'm going to bring my palette knife back in and just make kind of a slurry with this. That looks pretty good. And once I've got it all mushed in there, I'll grab a brush. So this is a fan brush, and this is not what I would do if I were going to apply a wash to a surface, but it is what I would do if I'm going to spatter. So if I were going to apply a wash to a surface, let's just say I'm going to grab this brush, and this is going to be probably a very thin wash here because I don't have a lot of product. But you can see that I can brush this on. It becomes a little bit more transparent, but I can still see the shimmer now. I don't know if I can get that to reflect in the light, but there it is. It's really there, and it's just as nice, and it allows you to actually add color in ways that you might not ordinarily consider when working with a product like this. So I'm going to thin this out some more, and let's bring, what do we got here? This is the piece from a moment ago. Let's just bring this in. Now I have a fair amount of water, so that means I'm going to get good-sized drops. So when I do that, you can see I get that really, that spatter pattern. If I have less water on here, I'm going to just tap some of this off. You see as I start to tap a little bit more lightly, I can get really fine dots. If I want really big dots, and this is just kind of the way spattering works, this has nothing to do with the product. The more water you have, the bigger the dots you're going to get. Well, that wasn't a very good example, was it? So let's really go crazy with the water and see if we can get some bigger dots there. There you go. So you can see what happens. But the point here is that you can take what's left on your surface, you can thin it and make a wash, you can use that same thin material for spattering. You can, I mean, if you want to start doing patterns with a fan brush like this, it's really easy to do, and you can play and create. It's all about texture and layers and patterns when we work in journals and do those fun mixed media kinds of things. And working with something like a fan brush and this really nice gilding polish is a way to achieve all those fun layers and patterns and texture.